here. I'm Lakshmi Sharma, Head of Product Management Networking at Google Cloud. I'll be taking you through some strategies or some key technologies in open source, as well as inside Google that we have been using to help enterprises onboard and take their journey in hybrid space, as well as ourselves. This company has been doing data center and doing that at scale, cloud at scale, network at scale. So we'll touch upon some of the technologies and how we are leveraging them inside. And now is the time that we are ready to externalize that so that other enterprises and providers can leverage all the automation and the infrastructure that we have built over scale over years. So key agenda items would be, we'll talk about some trends in enterprise migration journey or hybrid journey. Then we'll touch upon what is Google doing in this space, like how do we have the reach which is global, what kind of automation do we put, what kind of security do we have, all of automated and using SDN and services and virtualization, which is running at scale. What is the security and how do we automate all the way from application to data at rest and connectivity, all of them. And then how is all that coming together? And how is that whole, and then we are taking that, and as I said, like externalizing it with technologies like Kubernetes through GKE, istio, service mesh, how is it all coming together and how we have taken the experiences of Google and running at scale and offering it out and working with other providers in open source community. So a quick cloud evolution slide, and most of you must be familiar. How enterprises started was we started with data centers. We started with proprietary software, monolithic software. And then the first step was hardware virtualization, tens of years ago. And that was really a drive towards, like, how do I optimize my cost? How do I, minimize my TCO, total cost of ownership? And then going to past 20 years had been, I would say 15 years, were focused more and around like infrastructure as a service. And that's when some of the cloud providers started coming in play. Infrastructure as a service, compute, agility around storage. So how do we get that so that still, but most of the focus and most of the critical applications continue to stay on-prem? So it's really the drive towards applications, drive towards how do I run my services and optimize them, optimize the operations of the services, optimize the use and manageability so that I'm not spending all my time looking at multiple dashboards in various places as an enterprise IT. So that's where I believe the true cloud and the cloud native has really helped us. And you see the growth in Kubernetes and containers. I believe that's the reason, because now enterprises have done total cost of ownership, cost optimization. We have looked at agility and around storage and compute. How do we now take our applications which are sitting on the same infrastructure for like 20 and maybe sometimes 40 years? So what the right technology that came in, and then Google had been using it for many years, which is put all your services where the user is or where the end customer is. So doing that at scale, and it's in place for many years, which the things called containers, and leveraging that containerized infrastructure at a scale of automation, at a scale of connectivity. So that's so this company called Google has been doing it for many years, as I said, and we are just taking it next step now with the various open source and other technologies that you hear. So some trends that we are observing. So this slide is if you look at say right side of me, and the trend in terms of spends, it still talks about like how much of the investment is still happening on-prem. Right, so 53%, 57% of the investment is still happening in on-prem technologies and converged technologies, hyper-converged technologies. So, and it's although you see the spend in cloud last year and this year growing like almost 200%, but still the mix suggests that investment will continue both on-prem as well as cloud. And the driver towards cloud, if you see at the right bottom, are open source technologies, right? Enabling open source technologies, lot of tooling and automation that can connect on-prem and cloud, that can connect multiple clouds. So the trends are already talking about that. It is already hybrid. Investment is going into that space. So as easy as we can make to make that hybrid journey in terms of tooling, like you talked about, making it simple, simple to deploy, simple to develop, simple to automate, and giving the seamless experience around that. We know that this is reality. We know that the investment is happening in both the places. So whether using hyper-converged infrastructure, putting that into on-prem, or using APIs, or using seamless application and abstraction layer, that's where the growth is happening, and then the data suggests that. So again, around modernization of IT infrastructure. So if you look at like a horizontal, like across different kinds of applications and different verticals, let's say, whether it is an IoT application or whether it is just an e-commerce or say network visibility visualization application, if you see the trend of migration of those applications from enterprise IT to cloud, you will still see that if we go to like Gartner's kind of 4 hours or retire, re-architect, redesign kind of model of how you modernize your applications, there hasn't been a perfect kind of mix yet. You always kind of start with thinking that, I have these 70-year-old applications, I would be able to retire all of them. But you end up really kind of most of being in the mix, and that's what this chart suggests that, which is a mix of lift and shift plus modernizing your application. So the green, which is showing, which is 47% for reporting, customer-facing web. So these numbers are saying that it is going to be a mix, which again matches on to the data that you saw on the previous screen. So it is hybrid. Investment is talking, you know, is going in that direction. Open source is enabling it. And application migration, the data out there also suggests that it is not just going to be lift and shift of an application from an enterprise IT to a cloud. It is going to be a combination of you rewriting, re-architecting applications, and then leveraging the cloud or leveraging the resources on-prem. So with that, we'll get into like little more details of how Google is doing it, how our infrastructure with which that we had been operating at scale and the network at scale and using SDN, using automations, using our SRE-based practices. So we'll get to that, and from that onwards, we'll go through each layer. We'll start with infrastructure, we'll touch upon SDN, then we'll talk about applications, and then we'll see how services are being built, managed, and automated at scale. And then I'll have Srinath take you through the infrastructure journey.
Thank you. So like Lakshmi mentioned, Google has been building these large-scale applications which need to span the globe. And we've been using our technology to, we've focused on building what we think is one of the largest and most efficient SDN networks that spans the globe. And when we decided to move to Google Cloud, one of our key focuses was how can we take that network and that infrastructure and bring it to you, our customers, and make it available for you so that we can manage the SDN and the complexity of the network and the underlying ecosystem so that you can focus on what's important to you, which is your applications and the services that you want to provide to your customer. So to that end, we've been focused on building a truly global cloud, and we've invested over $30 billion over the last 3 years towards this end, and we have regions, as you can see, which span the globe, and we also have points of presence, which are really close to where your customers truly exist. So that way, we are able to connect you to your customer in ways that have never been possible before. So, and all of these different regions and zones that we have are connected using Google's global network. We've been working on building this network for over 10 years now. And this network is the underlay for our entire SDN ecosystem, which is based on Andromeda. And there's a great Andromeda SDN talk later today that I would encourage all of you to listen to. But our vision was to use this network and to provide value to you so that you can pass that value on to your customer. And to that end, we've been focusing on innovating in the areas of our network and our software-defined stack with Andromeda, where last year we announced Andromeda 2.1, which has now had eight times the improvement in terms of latency from when it originally got started. And all of these eventually get passed on to you as our customer. And when it comes to hybrid and trying to deploy these when you want to deploy to the cloud or when you want to move to the cloud, it's essential that you have easy access and easy points where you can get onto the cloud network. To this end, we have various dedicated interconnect access points and partner interconnect access points where you can have dedicated channels to connect you from your on-prem infrastructure to the cloud. And finally, all this is built with security on top of our mind. We've built it in such a way that we focus on a defense in depth security strategy. So right from the platform and all the way at the basics, we build with security in mind at every single step. And we pass that on to you in terms of bring your own key kind of capabilities, which let you manage your encryption. And we always encrypt by default to make sure all the data that's on the cloud infrastructure is secure. So by doing this, we're able to deliver this kind of a, we let you focus on the applications and the services that you want to deliver by giving you the underlying SDN infrastructure, which is built with these fundamentals in mind in terms of high quality, high throughput network, which is built with security and as the focus so that you can deliver value to your customers. With that, Lakshmi will go a little bit deeper into the applications.
So that was a kind of, you know, quick pitch on what's there with Google. And then it's important to just see that, see all of that in action, because when we talk about SDN, when we talk about NFV, like prior to being at Google, my view was that, you know, it's a function which you will have to rewrite. It's a firewall. It's some kind of, you know, DPI appliance or DDoS appliance. And then you connect them through some kind of service chaining, and then you automate and orchestrate. To me, the eye opener to me was that when you really need to do that at scale, that has to be done fundamentally in the network. So when you see this network, we are talking about a software-defined DDoS, which is running at that scale that you saw. We are talking about SDN driving the scale of the endpoints, the billions of users connecting to that network. So it's all real. So SDN is real. I know we know that it is real, but I'm just talking about that from an implementation perspective. That's why it's so simple to automate and scale and talk about all of that hybrid. And so just giving a different kind of view of SDN at scale, NFV at scale, virtualization automation at scale, just visibility analytics just running across the layers, every single point that you see on the scale. It just imagine what value Google has, you know, received or has been able to offer to everybody else, because network function virtualization has been running at scale in that environment for years. So there are huge advantages of doing it and doing it really fundamentally at the basic layer. So some other input, so when we say SDN inside Google running or automation, our container orchestration management system. So inside Google, we had been using something called Borg, which you can imagine as a container orchestration management system, which deploys security policies, which does all the identity management, all of that running on billions of kind of applications and services. We took that system that we have internally and running our infrastructure on and externalize it in the name of Kubernetes. So when you go towards Kubernetes, think of it being already used out there at the scale that we are talking about for Google. So something, containers real, like billions of containers running every week across all services around the world. And so if you are thinking about running at that scale, and if there is a use case that you can, you know, see in action here. So some of the building blocks that we are focusing on and we are leveraging inside. So yes, great idea to have, like, you know, different components at the network level. Yes, let's just re-architect, redesign our applications, use container, microservices. But then how do you detect those services? How do you discover those services? What are the service mesh going to look like? What is the boundary or the zones of your applications? So to put all of that together, we have been investing and working in open source and community on the istio site to bring the control plane and the data plane capabilities at the service abstraction layer. So we build the SDN layer, and then we brought, like, container management, and then you use istio to discover the services and do it at across different hybrid endpoints. So you're talking about abstraction layer that runs from your cloud to another cloud all the way to on-prem. And then we worked with companies like, again, in open source community, companies like Cloud Foundry to come up with an open service broker. So you have APIs now that can connect you with different versions of Kubernetes, different types of, you know, and GKE being one of our managed instances. So there is already that ecosystem which is working, and there are a lot of partners and community, you know, investment I hope that you all see as well, which is bringing all these applications running and services running at scale through the ecosystem of these communities that I'm bringing here. So what else can you actually do? So when, if you have figured out, if you, and like, you know, and I can take our example, our cloud, which is running GKE, which is a managed version of Kubernetes, which is integrating all 30 parties, all the way to like key management we talk about, all the way to services management, to firewall management, all of it is being already integrated into that framework of containerized applications. So all you need to do then is that you can really start focusing on the next level of value add from your own cloud. So in our case, like, you know, we, the reason that we are able to get focus more on machine learning, and then we are able to focus on just being able to apply more of defense, more of DDoS protection right at the edges, just really making the cloud secure, because the management across different clouds, bringing other enterprises onto our cloud, that's really easy. So just standardizing across these APIs, standardizing across these ecosystems, like istio, you know, istio to me feels like will be that service level API and automation and orchestration system, in addition to GKE/Kubernetes, that can really enable your journey of hybrid IT, that can make that goal happen for most of the ITs. So what are the advantages that you're seeing by bringing the service level abstraction and being able to really focus as an enterprise IT, focus on the benefits that you want to bring in from the cloud. So once you, if you do not have to worry about where my headquarter is as an enterprise, where my stores are, or where my branches are, if all of that could be just handled by and discovered, and your developers could be focusing on just writing application, and you have a system like a container management system, or you have a service discovery system, or you have a service mesh, then your journey from going from writing the code as a developer to promoting that into production, if that becomes seamless, you are really talking about taking away at least 50 to 60% of the effort that is happening today in just making that real. And imagine each enterprise doing it, each cloud provider or every developer doing it. It will make their life so easy. And at least we have seen it, and we hear from customers all the time. So another, and that also kind of, you know, brings the ecosystem together. So now if you look at this slide, so working with, as I said, like Pivotal Cloud Foundry, which is in, you know, which is giving a lot of input into service broker API, so that all the ecosystem around Kubernetes can come together. Then working with like partners like Red Hat through OpenShift, that they have their own very, very evolved service templates and service APIs within the container management and the Kubernetes framework. And working with Cisco, who is very, really good, and they have established base in enterprise, using them in the hyperconverged infrastructure, using them for enterprise onboarding, leveraging that knowledge and bringing Kubernetes onto their hyperconverged infrastructure. So this whole show, all these components that I just talked about, just talking, and that could be possible only when, because we were able to get to the containers, we were able to take infrastructure, operating system out of the application, and applications could be seamlessly deployed because of that separation that has happened over years and through the technologies like containers and service discovery just working at the application level. So that all the partner ecosystem for a company like us that became possible because of these technologies, and we are getting a lot of value out of it. We hear customers every single day talking about it and the advantages that they have seen. So, you know, I would encourage you all to also, if you're not going to KubeCon, I was not here to just pitch about that, but, you know, do check it out next week. There will be a lot of kind of customers and partners talking about what they had been doing in the cloud, you know, in that space. So with that, you know, my talk comes to an end. Thank you.
Thank you.